short of it. The boat now. Sure, what's going on? I'm sure this will reach over there and grab you without dropping you off the boat. That'd be nice. Alrighty. Now, before somebody says y'all be welding that with stick, I like the wire because that's, you know, let's see, I started right there, right? And I had four little holes from wind. I'm just putting some patches over. I'm not going to do any more than that. But you know, stick was an advantage because you can weld in the wind, it doesn't matter. MIG has an advantage that you can weld without stopping, so you get, in my opinion, a lot more welding done than you have with stick. And nobody has to pick up all those little stubby sticks laying around on the ground. It just 44 pound spool of wire in there and it just keeps on coming. Okay. Show you the introduce you to Peter. Oh, I have to take you down. Well, I'll show you down inside of there. There's down inside the hole, and those are all the tiles that we're working on with the inscriptions. And that's a pile that we're going to cut. So the deal is to put them in along the side here. And Peter here is a woodworker, so he'll get the job of doing that. Say good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
Tell him your last name, Peter.
Cog.
Say it again.
Cog.
I'm getting my name changed to that.
My last name's Mud if I don't get this job done.
Yeah. Let's show you what they've been doing. Oh, yeah. We built this little table yesterday, and it's designed to go on the boat because we have on the bottom of it holes for 3/4 inch bolts at a 2 foot center square. And so it can be bolted down anywhere below. And we're also going to put the same boat pattern. Oh, yeah, he wants to show you the handle. Yeah. So it's got wheels on the other side that are only in contact when the table's tilted. There were swivel wheels. A weld took care of that. So see, those wheels are touching the ground, but they're not really resting on it. Oh, they are a little off, aren't they?
They're about...
What, you got about an eighth inch?
Eighth inch.
Yeah. So then you slide the handle out and it's on the wheels all of a sudden by just a little bit of a pitch. Am I about to throw that in the floor?
No.
No bolt holes yet on that, huh?
No.
No, he's getting ready to... Wait. I hate them mounted in the center of the table. I like it on the corner.
Okay.
The reason being is I can... I think I can get longer pieces of material in. Yeah, like that. Yeah, because this one, the swivel base broke on it. That's why it's bolted on like this.
Okay.
Yeah. So just edge it up as close as you can to the corner at a 45, and that's for some reason I like that better. Because I think what I can do is I can drop material off that side or this side of the jaw.
Yeah, I never thought of that.
Yeah. There we go. And then I guess put that wire wheel on the other. Wait a minute. That wire wheel spins this way, so its brush is going to be right here.
Okay.
So put that on the opposite corner. Yeah. Yeah, and just let the brush hang out as far as it will. Because this is going to be for aluminum work mainly. It's a stainless wire wheel brush. Yeah, and you know what? We're going to have to figure out a switch for this thing. Like maybe just right here on the leg.
Just put a plug on it.
And then just plug it in.
Put a switch box on it.
Yeah. Let's put a switch box. We'll put it
then
close.
Wire it in and then.
Yeah. You know what else would be cool? A switch box and another plug. Even better.
So you can plug the vise in.
So we can plug the vise in. That's right. Let's see. We got the doublers cut for the back of this, but nothing else has happened back here yet. See, there's the looking down at the rudder down below there. She's still hanging up, and there's where our Samson posts are going in. And, hey, Peter, you got those, you in the mood to do some more grinding? We got the Samson posts down below that have to be ground up. Maybe after this, so we don't have to listen to you. Okay. So that's what's going on the boat. All the outside welds are done, and the rough part of it's been knocked off. A lot of welding on the back end of it this weekend, or actually at nights, part of last weekend. I'm gonna show you. Oh, we gotta grind that too. Forgot about that. But without the, now that the, we took the rudder out so we could get the bushings out, and now we've got the welding done around the rudder tube. The tube is just the part that the shaft goes through, and the rudder shaft is that thing hanging down there with the bushing dangling on the end of it there. Okay, and the lawnmower got fixed. Yeah. I actually need to drain some water out of our test tank now because the thing's so stinking full, they're underwater. I guess we'll give a submerged test. Betsy is sewing up a test piece for us. Are we live? Is it working?
Yes.
It looks like it is. I see a picture. There it is. Oh, that's cool. Look at the delay on that. Not too bad. Not too bad at all. And we've got all the patches and sewing. Are we done with the sewing? Yeah, we're done with the sewing on the mizzen sail. And this is it. And the mizzen sail is the small one. And it's small by a factor of 5 compared to the mainsail. So we got some big sailboats. We did some learning on this too. You want to say anything about this?
You.
We're going to do some things different. We're really glad we started on the small one. That was not by accident. But what we've learned is that, well, we, how did we do this? You did this. That's a panel right there. In other words, this is a seam. That's that cloth to right here started off as 62 inches wide by however long we needed. And it got a French seam right there, which means it's cupped under a 3/4 inch on the bottom, and the top one's done the same, and then they're sewed together. So it wastes an inch and a half. This is called a fault seam, where you score it, and then you just take the material and bunch it up and then lay it over, and no food. I swear, no food.
Now, our theory of this is, because I've not seen this written anywhere.
The false seam or?
Well, both. The false seam and the reason we have these little panels, we didn't just run the fabric
across. Yeah, one big piece all the way across.
Is if it rips.
Right.
It shouldn't.
It won't cross those.
Rip more than one of these little panel things. It shouldn't cross.
Yeah.
Unless we are in so much trouble that is the least of our problems.
Right. And they kind of act like. Yeah.
Okay,
just lay
we'll
down
find
there.
Another one.
They kind of act like a reinforcement piece. Because you can see it's that right there is a strength member going from this would be the top toward the bottom, which you call it the boom if you like. I'm not picky about boat terms. And then the rope back behind you here.
Well, did you talk about the batten?
Oh, I didn't talk about the batten. And okay. So there's another panel that's sewn on here that is only on this side because there's a batten that lays across this side.
It's 3 layers additional, so.
Yeah, it adds 3 more layers. It's actually doubled under from both edges, so.
And then it has a piece inside.
And then it has a piece inside that's just there, so it's 3 layers added to it for the batten support. And underneath it is just a seam like that. And then the batten lays on this side, so now grommets are going to go in, those little ring things. So there'll be, you know, some there, 2 here, and 2 there, and then on down. And what happens is the batten lays down in here. And I'm looking at somebody was using, you know, the rope is a traditional thing. You know, you run a rope down, go through, wrap it over, loop it back under and go down to the next one. But we figure if the rope breaks, the whole batten comes out. And other people have started using, of all things, zip ties. The cheap ones last, you know, almost less than a year. Good ones last 3 years. But I looked online last night and I found, what do they call them? They're called strapping. You know, when you get a package in, something's strapped down to a pallet or as a big carton that has a plastic strap. Those poly, they use, polypropylene, and the other strap type was a polyester. Yeah, So you can get strapping material in those two, and those will last considerably longer outside.
Poly, did they?
Yeah. Well, it's all good. It's all based on chemicals from the natural gas industry, which supports my paycheck.
Oil and gas.
Drill, okay.
Drill.
Yeah, that's right. Guys, take a long summer vacation this year. Drive as many miles as you can, okay? We need oil prices back up.
And buy lots of natural gas for winter.
Yeah, get a hot tub, okay? And a sauna and a spa and all those things. Make sure they're gas operated. Actually, don't do that because it's really expensive. But anyway, so we sewed these, you know, this one to that one, and she stacked them going this way up. And we decided that's not the way to do it because what it does, it leaves us with this curve that has to be, so this big panel had to be sewn to that big panel along a curve.
That curve was nasty.
That makes it a lot harder. And then there's another curve out there where the last panel got sewed on. So what we're going to do next time is we're going to sew
the verticals.
Yeah, we're going to sew the...
No.
Yeah, we're going to... No, not the vertical. No, we're going to sew them horizontal. And then we're going to use that. But that means we have... I know why you did that. It's because we could do the patch.
We can still do it. My mind wasn't thinking. The deal is, before I sew, when we put... Okay, we put this one on. We sew that seam. We put this patch on. Then I go to the next one.
Oh,
my brain was thinking... I sewed them all up, and then I had to put the patches
on. So all we have to do is roll up, like, 4 feet. Sometimes it's 6 feet when it gets to be big into the sail. It actually goes up to, like, 7 feet.
But
these things get taller.
15 panels, no two alike. Oh, and show them your patches.
Oh, yeah, no two panels are alike. So there's no, get a template and cut it out, all the panels. They're all different. And so these are patches. This is the last thing that went on. Is this one was textbook, and that one over there is textbook, but I decided, hell, I'm going to put one across the yard, too, because I figure that's where the most stress is. And there's grommets that go along there that strap it to a largest beam called a yard, a pipe up there. We're going to start off using aluminum pipes, I think. But anyway, a lot of good work done there. Oh, and the rope. Yeah, the rope. We found on sale at a tremendous price from JR Rope. Somebody had this on sale. It's red Dacron, three strand. There's actually three strands of rope on there. And you can braid this stuff. There's lots of videos on that. We're not actually braiding it. We kind of spliced it at one point. But anyway, what happens is I think we put a stitch through here and then here and here. And we sew this beast to the edge of the sail.
Manually,
yeah. So we're going to have to figure out a way of poking holes through this. And I haven't seen what I think is a good solution. You know, there's awls and hammers and punches and presses and that sort of thing. I think we're going to burn them through. I think I'm going to put a nail on the end of our hot knife and heat that sucker up and just drive them through. Now here we may be able to just sew that with a needle. And what's that thing called, a palm, that you press the needle through the...
Yeah, that's three layers.
Yeah,
there.
But this is actually the rope. This is 3/8 inch. This is the rope that will go on to this sail. So it gets...
And it matches so well.
I think it gets sewn like that, so that it's actually would be on the other side, away from the battens. Anyway, if somebody knows how to rope a sail, we think it goes here, not out here on the edge. That just doesn't make sense. Because what it's supposed to do is, this takes the weight of the whole sail, and it transfers the weight of each of the battens. Yeah, so.
You got people here from places that I've not been.
Yeah?
Yeah, Latvia.
Latvia?
Latvia.
We have a couple that came by this morning. He'll be back to work. Sunshine and Wesley from Thailand.
France, the UK, Northern Ireland.
Really?
Yes.
That's
you
great.
You ran off. You left me.
Oh, I'm sorry. What else have we got to show?
Netherlands, Toledo, Ohio, DeKalb, Illinois.
We had somebody from Toledo here the other week. Was it Nathan? Nathan from Toledo?
No, Nathan was from somewhere up there. Nathan was from, Lansing, Michigan.
Lansing, Michigan, that's right.
Man, if there's a test, hey, you know what you need to show them?
What?
Go out there and show them Peter's van and where he's putting the states in when he gets to them. Did you see that?
He's traveling across the United States.
It's pretty cool.
Peter came here from, I got him out on the street now.
Denmark.
Oh, you moved him?
Yeah, Denmark.
But he's living down in Tampa. He works down there, right? Isn't it somewhere near Tampa?
No, Clearwater.
That's near Tampa.
Oh, yeah, that's right. It's right outside Tampa, isn't it?
Oh, my Lord.
Hey, I've only been there once in my life. And man, the traffic was impressive. This is the other thing we gotta do. We gotta finish our mask. I'd like to do that. And what she's talking about, she's traveling across the United States. Oh, we'll get you a view of the boat. Now we may glitz out here, because I'm getting a long way from my Wi-Fi. We'll back off. We don't get to see the boat from outside very often. So he's got a mobile camper here. I asked him about the numbers, and it seems to be a family tradition. So he has he's number 47. I thought it was the answer to the universal question. It's not. That's 42. So there's where he's been. He gets to, yeah, he's already got Kansas and Oklahoma filled in. He did that this morning. Look at that. He made a swing through Missouri and Kansas on his way here, so. You might see this thing cruising down the highway in your neighborhood someday. And there we are. There's our whole boat, our trailer. All right. Did I fade out? Yeah. Well, it won't on YouTube. It'll work there. Were you going to bark at me? And we did have to put up the dog will bite sign because... You bit the UPS guy. It's like, of all people to bite. Really? So now we've got dog treats out there for the UPS guy so he can train her not to bite. Oh, it's still out there. That's funny, the strays haven't picked it up yet. Dogs killed a rabbit yesterday. Jezebel, man, opened the door of the shop, flashes out the door, nails it. Let's see. All right, we got anything else? Are we done? Can I go back to welding? Oh, I had a question.
You're back on.
Yeah, I had a question about the straps. I was on to, you know, that we're going to hold those battens. Yeah, sorry, you're crooked. We're going to hold those battens onto the sail, and I was telling you about zip ties, but there's those straps. I need one. Man, I found it the other night, but it was expensive. It was like for 100 of them, it was $350. They're $3.50 a piece. Maybe it's worth it, a piece. But they were stainless steel covered with nylon. And it had the tool to ratchet them down. And, you know, the tool, we can't use...
Okay, if you have to have a special tool.
Yeah, I don't mind.
And something happens to the special tool because heaven forbids we never lose anything.
Then you get, you need to put a hose clamp on it to, or a wire tie to you, replace the tool. The tool is only about, 80
I don't believe in things that
bucks.
There's one tool that only works one thing.
I know, it's not a
I
great
I don't
thing.
Believe in that.
But maybe we can, I think we could fake the tool.
Because that takes up space where I could be putting my own stuff.
Yeah, the tool was a thing that clamps onto the strap and shoves against the, you also have these special clips that go with it too. And it pulls, and then you fold the clip over, and it clamps it down shut. But I'd like a simpler system. So if you guys have used any of those things, or you know the tool, or maybe there's a YouTube video out there of how to make the tool. It didn't seem like that difficult of a tool. $80 didn't really bother
me. So what's wrong with the black 3/8 inch zip ties?
What's wrong with the black 3/8 inch zip ties? Maybe nothing's wrong with them. Maybe they'll last, maybe a year is fine.
I think... When we raise this sail in the backyard,
we'll know.
We do with 3/8 inch zip ties.
That's a great plan. We'll see. But we're not going to leave it up for a year.
No, but I mean, still.
Yeah. 3/8 inch zip ties. I don't have 3/8. How much are 3/8 inch zip ties?
They're a lot less than what you're talking about.
They're not $350 a piece.
And they don't take extra tools.
Yeah. And maybe they make something better than just your standard zip tie. Maybe they make something that's actually UV.
Well, they said the black ones are UV. Well, when they sell them.
Well, I think it's because they're made out of a different plastic that just holds up better. I don't think they actually stabilize it anyway. The sailcloth we're using, by the way, is—I was wrong. It's not Sunbrella. It's Top Gun something.
It's Top Gun 62-inch, 11-ounce, by Marlin. That's who makes it. Marlin.
Marlin?
Yeah.
That's the manufacturer of Top Gun?
Mm-hmm, and they're in Missouri, which is probably why they drop shipped us.
That's why I got here, like, 2 days after we ordered it. Yeah. It's kind of a semi pulled down the street, and we unloaded all this stuff sitting in the back of my truck. Yeah, my truck now has $7,000 worth of sailcloth in it, which drastically raises the value of my truck. Let me know if you find something that's bigger than this and 3/8. I'd even go with a 1/2 inch because those the ones I was looking at were 1/2 inch wide.
And
well,
half online inch, they're 3/8 inch, and I can't remember the price, but a lot of people have them.
Oh, and
it was not a problem.
And the other thing we're working on next that maybe some of you know better about, I don't think these are deep enough. But Betsy's sewing up some test material here this morning, and we're going to try them out because we got some spots on the sail that are really thick. And let me just use your piece here as a temporary example. So what happens is we got to poke a hole through this. We got a die and a punch for that. Actually, it's just a punch that goes into the wood.
This thing.
Yeah. So the first thing you do to put a grommet in is you punch a hole, right? And this is a 1/2 inch punch. And you go on the wood as on the back side for that. And then you put a grommet through from the bottom side. And it's got, this is a toothed grommet. And then the other side goes, I just don't think, we got pieces on the sail that I don't think we're going to be able to get enough of that flange up through there. Because then what happens is you got somebody crawls underneath the sail and positions that. And it's not even a great fit. It fits the brass ones really good. I know. And then your sailcloth is, you know, that's coming up through the hole in your sail. And then that goes on.
How come this attitude of yours that we have to be able to cast anywhere, even in the beach sands, when it comes to things like this, if something isn't perfectly fitted and perfectly right, you get a little weird? Mm-hmm. You notice that? You're very forgiving.
How many of these are we going to be doing?
Well, in the little sail, there's only like 112.
There's only 112 in the little sail.
And the big sail's 5 times the size.
Are you crawling underneath the sail and positioning this then?
No, that you have Bart.
Oh, Bart gets to do it.
It's Bart.
But anyway, Bart had this beautiful idea. There's a thing called I forgot the name of it. They use it for pressing. Somebody will know. You can post it here. It's not a press, because a press wouldn't work, because we gotta have 1/2 the sail rolled up and stick underneath this thing. So it has to have, you know, it's called an arbor press. So we need something where the it doesn't have these beams on the side, but it can reach out, and so the sail bundle can come back underneath here, and it can press a grommet in. And on the big sails, we'll sew one panel on across the way, and then we'll put the patch on, and then we'll put all the grommets on, and then we move to the next section of the sail. That way we only have to reach across 1 6-foot section of the sail, roll it up, which will actually fit through the sewing machine.
Or we need a piece of 3'6" log so Bart can crawl underneath and position it properly.
Yeah, but I'm thinking of an arbor. And his idea is take an arbor press, cut the arm off of it, and extend it, on a beam so that we can get further away and just make it easier to put the sail under. And then,
are you still going to get the same leverage?
Oh, it's better because they want you to have wood mallet to drive this, and they want a soft blow and not the sheer force of the hammer.
Can you do that?
Yeah.
Could you do soft blow and not sheer force?
Yeah.
That boat was built by sheer force.
I got rubber hammers out over there, so I can use the rubber mallet or a wooden mallet. So the better way, they say, of putting these on is actually to use a press.
Now, another question is grommet size.
Yeah.
Basically,
this is a number 4.
It's telling us we should use 3s because if we won't, but I think. But
smaller,
in Doug's theory is
three smaller, right?
The bigger the grommet, the stronger it is because
there's more surface area.
But there's also a bigger hole in the middle, and if it doesn't fill it, it'll
steel.
Wobble it.
This is stainless.
Yeah, well.
Yeah.
Should we talk about tornadoes and the steel boat again?
Yeah. Nah, this is, I think a bigger grommet, well, bigger grommets are designed for heavier loads. So, I'm happy with this, because I get a half inch strap through there, except it'd make the strap kind of curve. This would go through easily, a 3/8 would go through easily. So I think we do our normal thing, we just try it and see. I think that for that sale, I think this size is more than enough. This
so
is
not
four.
Threes,
not
you
threes,
think
I think fours.
All right.
Because that way, it'd be nice to have one band across all sails. That way it's like you get one zip tie out and you've got the right size zip tie. And then the hole's perfect for whatever size zip tie that is.
Okay.
Anyway, got ideas. Let us know about that. It'd be mighty appreciative of it.
For those things to seal and crimp properly, a mallet works better. That is from David Gary Barris.
No, I don't think so, David. Unless you wrote the book. And from what I've seen and from reading the books, a press puts the pressure on more evenly and bends it over nicer.
Well,
I've used
Lucy
a mallet. I've seen you can really screw it up.
George Lucy said it was a year ago he was here being a grinding god.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Well, where are you now, George? Huh?
He's painting little things in Wyoming.
He's making mead.
No, and he's painting little people.
Is he?
He's a little people painter.
Yeah. That sends us a picture of your little people painting.
Well, it's on his Facebook. Haven't you seen his Facebook? He's got little people
No,
painting.
I haven't seen
Well,
his
they're
Facebook.
Not people. You know they're warriors.
Oh.
You know?
You mean like World of Warcraft
But
stuff?
At least I know. Yeah, probably. I don't know about that.
Yeah.
I would think if we ever get the Doug Jackson action figure, case sold separately.
We're not
going to
do that.
George could paint them all.
Did you catch that? Case sold separately? That's funny.
That is funny. You thought of that originally, didn't you?
No, I think that was yours.
No, it wasn't mine.
No,
it was yours.
No, I'm not going to take credit.
It was yours.
I'm not taking
credit. It was Drew Morgan. That's who did it.
Yeah, we'll call it. Yeah. Okay, we'll say it was Drew.
Okay.
All right. We got anything else?
No, but you got Peter here, and Sunday night we're picking up Norman.
Norman will be in from Germany, and he'll be here for 3 weeks, and he welds.
Yes, and he does. Awesome. He has some hydraulic knowledge as well, which could be interesting.
Yeah.
Because he might.
Yeah,
he might. He interned in hydraulics.
Interned in hydraulics. I think interns don't get to do.
And then, after Norman, then we have the fun-filled weekend of hacking the wild Seeker style.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, Andrew and Craig and
Kitty.
And somebody else they're bringing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So if you haven't watched Hacking the Wild, you can probably see them all for free now on sciencego.com.
Yeah.
So you get to know Andrew, so you will know him when he's here.
Yeah.
Because you'll want to meet him.
And it's a good show. I mean, it was.
Okay.
Especially for youngers.
Oh, now we're up to 34. You can't leave now.
Oh. Any questions? We got any questions out there?
David says, okay, he's got the tool, and he fitted a couple of those grommets. Maybe he didn't get enough pressure. Using the, I'm thinking he's talking about the...
Do you have a crimping tool?
The Harbor Freight's pressure thing. No, he says he thinks grommets are better. But he did get one of those...
You mean a mallet?
No, he thinks that works best. Yeah, the one you're talking about.
Oh, the press.
The Harbor Press. He says that...
That works better.
He
yeah,
said
they
he did
that,
better with a dead stop mallet than he did with the Harbor Freight press. Can you imagine?
He did better with a dead stop mallet.
Yeah.
So he likes the mallet better.
Yes.
Well, I think it's called a dead blow mallet.
Okay. Who cares? It's a dead something mallet.
I have one somewhere.
Well, who would know? It's so organized in here. We can't find anything.
Right here.
Oh, is that where the hammer box is?
That's a dead.
Well, let's see if it works. Dead.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Is it dead?
Dead. And listen. Yeah. It's got lead
Ooh,
shot.
If we have two of
or
them.
Or steel shot.
You stuff. Should have used these in the music video.
Did you pay attention?
We sailed away.
It's a little too short. So when you drive it in and it kind of not all hits at one time. So it gives some. Yeah, that would probably be.
Hey, probably is there anybody out there that has used a miser saw?
What's a miser saw?
That's what Nosek has. The wood miser.
Oh, a wood miser.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A wood miser, what's it called? Lumber?
Something 20 something.
You know, it's a big thing that you
it's
cut big
log. Yeah,
saw,
it's a bandsaw.
Anybody experienced with wood misers? Because
yeah, we could use you.
We could use you.
Well, Paul's going to give us some training on it, too.
But we could use you.
Next Sunday might be a good day to do that. Yeah, then it could be nice to...
On Mother's Day?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
All righty.
Yeah. Mother's Day. Yeah. Okay, any questions there?
No.
We can't see back up the list a long way, guys, so if you had something, we're sorry.
No, I already looked up there.
Did you?
Yeah.
All right.
But
anyway.
They're here from all over the... Oh, don't forget, we have the new mugs in stock. Explore, dream, discover. A lovely pottery
finish.
You
need to wash your mug.
Well, okay, with a pottery finish. It's a matte finish with a glossy red interior. We have our Poseidon dragon on the front and these lovely words on the back, as well as a t-shirt you're not wearing. The maker shirt, you know, what did you make today? And we still have grinder gods. We have everything. It's just we don't have sizes in a lot of the older ones. And the black one, I'm not sure if we're going to print again, the boat the internet built. So you need to go to the website, look at the shop, and order now. Because we have 350 yards of fabric in the back of that truck with a bill to pay. Thank you.
Thanks, guys. Appreciate it. Have a great weekend. And what did you make today?
I remembered it.